Good evening, one and all. At the outset, I thank God and I thank the Academic Committee of IIM. Now, this is an MRI for your diagnosis. It's a nodule in the spinal canal, mildly enhancing the contrast. What does it look like? Audience interaction absolutely necessary. I made a mistake here. I want to know how many other people will make the same mistake. But even though I made a mistake, God was kind enough to me, which also I will tell you.
I have always wondered when neurosurgeons present these pictures. Like we pulmonologists take the AP lateral oblique views. Such views will identify the intraspinal location of this tumor.
Yes, it will.
Then where is it? Posterior, lateral, anterior.
Do you have a pointer? Sir, this is an axial view. The level is marked, T11. Now this is the spinal bony canal. Posteriorly, you see a white area. This is a T2 picture. So the fluid is white. This lesion which I am trying to show you is inside the spinal canal, intradural. Why intradural? Here you see the white area is CSF. The black area is the spinal cord going on into pons medullaris. Now you are able to clearly see that this black lesion in the T2 image, this is a T1 image in contrast. That is without contrast, this is with IV contrast. Now, therefore, this lesion is present inside the spinal canal, within the dura, but outside the spinal cord. Normally, in this area, T11, T10, up to L2, meningiomas and neurofibromas are common. Therefore, the first two in the differential diagnosis in this is neurofibroma bar meningioma. In a meningioma, I would have expected overall dense enhancement, a flat base towards the dura, and possibly flattening of the spinal cord over part of the lesion. Now that is seen in these two. In the axial section, you have a broad base towards the dura, which is seen only in this level. It is not seen in this level. Here you have peripheral enhancement over the superior end. So I thought this is an abnormal presentation of a neurofibroma. So with that in mind, not being prepared mentally to accept that this could be a meningioma, I opened the patient. This happened about 6 years ago. I found a friable tumor which was not attached to the dura at all. Even at this level, I could easily put my instrument between the dura and the lesion. There was no point of attachment. So I was very happy. In bits and pieces, I removed. Next slide, please. This is the part of the tumor. It did not feel like a meningioma. It did not look like a meningioma. I did not think it was a meningioma, but it was reported as a meningioma. Now, normally when we operate on meningioma, we try to identify the area of the dura where the tumor comes from and excise that piece of dura. In this case, after excision of that piece of dura, I would have had to put a fascia lata graft or other suitable muscle graft. But since I did not do that, I followed up this patient year after year to see if the meningioma would regrow. Normally, if we do not remove the dura and do not cauterize that area of the dura, the meningioma would come back in a year. It is 6 years since I operated, the meningioma has not come back. So I still have doubt in my own self that is it a neurofibroma or is it a meningioma? I brought it out here, go to the previous slide. For the fact that, no, next one, next slide. Sorry, for the peripheral enhancement, which is uncommon in a meningioma. Thank you.
I request Dr. Perumal to come forward and hand over the certificate of appreciation to Dr. Subramanian.